Hello friends, welcome to the lecture on hydraulics of wells under steady flow condition in unconfined aquifers. Up till now we have seen what is the meaning of aquifer, what are the kinds of aquifers like confined and unconfined aquifers. So today in this lecture we will see the hydraulics of wells under steady flow condition for unconfined aquifers. So let us start. This is the well operating in an unconfined aquifer. This is a definition sketch representing a well operating in an unconfined aquifer. As you can see, the well, it is shown by this particular dotted line. This is the impervious boundary. This is the original water surface and this is the ground surface, as you can see. So here you can see different terminologies like cone of depression, observation wells, drawdown, then drawdown curve. So we will see the terms to understand and later we will go with the well hydraulics. So consider the water in an unconfined aquifer being pumped at a constant rate from a well. Prior to the pumping, the water level in the well indicates the static water table. So initially when there is no pumping, the water level will be at a static water table level. A lowering of this water level takes place on pumping. As and when the pumping takes place, the water level will go down and lowering of water table will take place. If the aquifer is homogeneous and isotropic and the water table initially is horizontal, due to the radial flow into the well through the aquifer, the water table assumes a conical shape called as cone of depression. As you can see, whenever the water it is pumped out, the water in the vicinity of this well will assume the shape of this particular cone. So this is the cone of depression. The drop in the water table elevation at any point from its previous static level is called as drawdown. The aerial extent of the cone of depression is called area of influence and its radial extent is called radius of influence, as you can see. This is the radius of influence of the drawdown curve. At constant rate of pumping, the drawdown curve develops gradually with time due to the withdrawal of water from the storage. So this is the schematic diagram representing an unconfined aquifer from which the water it is being pumped at a constant rate, which results in this cone of depression, this drawdown curve and this radius of influence. So this will help us to understand the equation that we have to derive. So for the hydraulics of well, again the same thing it is represented over here. This is the drawdown curve. So let a non-artesian well be driven and water pumped heavily so as to cause sufficient drawdown. When the water level in the well decreases, the water level in the neighborhood will also be fallen down. An inverted cone of depression all around the well. The base of this cone is a circle of radius r. As you can see, this the base of this cone is a circle of radius r, that is the circle of influence, and the inclined side is known as drawdown curve. So we will first of all derive the equation of Thiem, the scientist, and then switch to the equation of Dupuit. Before the derivation, there are some assumptions. So what are the assumptions? Let us see. The aquifer is homogeneous, isotropic, and of infinite and aerial extent, so that its coefficient of transmissibility and permeability is constant everywhere. The well has been sunk through the full depth of the aquifer and it receives water from the entire thickness of the aquifer. Pumping has continued for a sufficient time at a uniform rate so that the equilibrium stage or steady flow conditions have reached. Flow lines are radial and horizontal and the flow is laminar. The inclination of the water surface is small so that its tangent can be used in place of sine for the hydraulic gradient in Darcy's equation. Already we have seen Darcy's equation, V is equal to Ki or capital Q is equal to Kia. So what is the Thames formula for unconfined aquifer case? So for understanding the Thames formula, let us see the sketch which is prepared. So here this particular well is the main well from which the water it is pumped at a constant rate. Bottom of this is the impervious stratum and the uppermost portion shows the ground level. This WT is the original water table and this is the main well from which the water is taken out. So as soon as the water is pumped out, the water level inside the well goes down by SW and the water level inside the well is what? HW. These are the observation wells, well 1 and well 2, separated by distance R1 and R2 respectively from the center of this main well. So the two observation wells lying within the circle of influence of the main pumped well are to be driven. Let these wells numbered as well 1 and well 2 as shown in the figure and let them be at a distance R1 and R2 from the main well. Center to center distance is measured here. Let small d be the depth of the well or the aquifer below the static water table. This d, it is represented over here. This small d be the depth of well or the aquifer below the static water table. Let the main well pumped at a sufficient rate so as to cause heavy drawdown. Then let the pumping be so adjusted that the equilibrium conditions are reached. That is, the rate of pumping becomes equal to the rate of yield and thus causing the water level to attain a constant value. Let S1 and S2 be the drawdowns in the corresponding observation wells at this equilibrium stage. So S1 and S2 be the drawdowns in the two corresponding observation wells at this equilibrium phase. So by Darcy's law, that is Q is equal to Kia, where Q is the discharge, where I is the hydraulic gradient using cylindrical coordinates. We take R as the radius of any cylinder and H as the height of cone of depression at a distance R from the main well. So to illustrate this, let us assume a small portion on this particular drawdown curve. Okay, if I consider this particular drawdown curve and if I consider a very small element of this, okay, suppose having distance dr, small dr, so it will have a triangular shape. It will have a height, it will have a base and it will have a triangular shape which is at a distance r from the main well. So it is shown like this over here. This is a portion of drawdown curve, small element on the drawdown curve. So this I, that is the hydronic gradient. It is what? It is dH upon dL, which is further equal to dH upon dR. So I is equal to dH upon dR. Then the area of flow is equal to 2 pi RH. Area of flow is equal to 2 pi R into H. H is the height of water. So Q, which is equal to KIA, can be replaced as K into dH upon dR into area 2 pi RH. So Q is equal to 2 pi K H into R dH upon dR. So rearranging the terms, dR upon R will be equal to 2 pi K H into dH upon Q. If we integrate this between the limits R1 to R2 and for the height limits H1 to H2, so integration dr upon r R1 to R2 will be equal to integration of 2 pi k upon q dh h into dh, where k is the permeability of the soil, which is assumed to be constant at all places and at all the times, that is homogeneous soil, and in all directions, that is isotropic soil. By assuming the soil to be homogeneous and isotropic, the value of K can be considered as a constant. So by simplifying this integration, that is dr upon r R1 to R2 is equal to 2 pi K upon Q, which is constant, integration of H1 to H2 H into dH. So log of R, log to the base E into R, R1 to R2 will be equal to 2 pi K upon Q H square upon 2 from H1 to H2 are the limits. Then log to the base E R2 upon R1 is equal to 2 pi K upon Q into bracket, by simplifying, H2 square up minus H1 square divided by 2, which is further equal to pi into K upon Q into bracket H2 square minus H1 square. So rearranging the terms, we will get K is equal to Q into log to the base E R2 upon R1 divided by pi into H2 square minus H1 square. Again, rearranging the terms, we can get this formula to find out the discharge as Q is equal to pi into K into bracket H2 square minus H1 square divided by 2.3 log to the base 10 R2 minus R1. Again, here H2 square minus H1 square can be rewritten as H2 square minus H1 square is equal to into bracket H2 plus H1 into H2 minus H1. H1 minus H2 is equal to S1 minus H2. H1 minus H2, as you can see, H1 minus H2 is equal to S1 minus S2. H2 minus H1 is equal to S1 minus S2. So here H1 plus H2, we can consider it as equal to D. This H1 and H2, they are not having so much difference, so that height can be considered as D. So H1 plus H2 can be considered as twice D, and H2 square minus H1 square can be written as S1 minus S2 into 2 times D, which is equal to 2D S1 minus S2. Therefore, by putting these values, the formula for discharge can be written as discharge is Q is equal to 2 pi K into D into bracket S1 minus S2 divided by 2.3 log to the base 10 R2 minus R1, which is further equal to 2 pi into T S1 minus S2 upon 2.3 log to the base 10 R2 upon R1. So by knowing the values of T, S1, S2, R2 and R1, you can find out the discharge for the well in an unconfined aquifer under steady flow conditions. Here T is the value of transmissibility. by using this particular equation K, you can find out the value of K if you know the other values of all the parameters. So either you can use this particular formula to find out K or Q. So I hope you have understood the equation. This is called as Dupitt's equation for an unconfined aquifer. So please go through the standard reference books as I have stated in this particular video. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me on my email address at dnpaitankarce@sanjeevani.org.in. Thank you for listening. Happy learning.